fun things out of Ganon Dittos. That said, you know, I do have a pretty unique vantage point, being that one of our PR level players in SoCal is arguably the best Richter main in the world in T3 Dom. So I'm so used to seeing all these ridiculous Richter follow-ups and like just crazy angles, and almost every Richter match I get to see turns me into that one gif of a lady with math around her head. She's really confused. Like, what?
Yeah. Well, I'm assuming Acetyl will, I know you're used to the best in the world, but he'll keep you impressed as well, because some of the stuff that this guy does is a little bit different too. But I'm excited for you to get into this. Now, let's talk about Frost real quick too. Frost is a top five player in the power rankings for SAK. And, you know, he's been trying to have a little bit of a character swap. He's been trying to go for a Roy. Roy, as you'll know, is a pretty popular character in the scene here today. But he's going back with the Chrom, because his Chrom is much stronger and it really suits his more defensive play style.
Yeah, I've definitely seen it in action, given that I was able to commentate the first Ascension, Welcome to Home, and he placed pretty high. I think it was top 8 at that. Right now, though, he's trying to recover, and he's just a couple of frames off, Laird. Oh, my gosh.
Dude, he went a little bit too high. He did it too early, because if he went low, he would have made it back, but he would have gotten clipped by the Holy Water, and he probably would have died to an F-Smash or something as well. Acetyl does not let those go to wayside.
This has to be one of the most volatile matchups in Smash, because both these characters get destroyed off stage.
Right, yeah. And neither of them can really edgeguard either, but the advantage definitely goes to the ledge trapping of Richter or Belmont, I think.
Oh yeah, this is definitely like where this matchup, you find out who's going to win and who's going to lose, is whether or not Frost can actually get in and past the volley of projectiles from the Richter.
And that F-Tilt would have killed any other character in the game, as would that one have, but Belmonts are pretty high weight. I think they're top 20 heaviest characters in the game.
Acetyl's doing a really good he's doing a really good job of hanging in there right now, Laird. Good escape pass, but can't escape the grab here. Frost trying to set up for a kill eventually, but this has to be tilting.
Now, here's the thing about Frost. He's got a very good mental. He's hard to shatter in any given moment, and he gets really patient in high-pressure situations like that, where most players would get desperate for a kill. He holds true, and the kills just seem to come to him.
Oh, what an excellent edge! You're talking about bad edge guarding? Acetyl just said, enough of that nonsense! That was an excellent drop-down bear to catch Frost in the worst possible position.
Acetyl took my words, and he grabbed it back down my larynx, bro.
Man. That's one way to make up what looked like an overthinking of a recovery option there at the axe at ledge. But now this is all Acetyl. That was such a momentum tipping option. Oh, he needed that grab to land to keep it up. Yeah, I can definitely see that so far. I'm really, really pleased here.
Yeah, the Krupp clan as a whole is very momentum-based in nature, but perfect timing. That's another thing about the Krupp brothers that you'll need to recognize as the night goes on. You'll see it probably a little bit with Krupp whenever he gets on stream later as well.
Absolutely.
But they have a really innate knowledge of when their opponent is recovering. They have really good timing on just hitting recoveries that don't snap to ledge immediately.
Totally. And one other thing to notice about Acetyl's play is that he's a lot more fond of using axe in neutral, especially a bait like jump up out of like projectile hits. But here we're watching the one thing that's really unfortunate about Chrom's recovery, which is that he has an active hitbox above ledge when he recovers like that. It's just really, really sad. But you know, more credit to Acetyl for picking that exact moment to capitalize with the tipper F smash.
Yeah, and look, that's what Chrom gets for trying to show off. You don't have to do those flips. You just need to go up and catch your sword. But no, he's got to do like 3 backflips first and then grab the ledge.
Okay, then you can see that Acetyl's trying to mix up how he wants to actually throw out that F smash one a little bit angled high, just in case Frost wanted to jump from ledge. So you can tell he's trying to make Frost overthink his recovery options at ledge.
Yeah, I've been seeing a lot of whiff grabs from Frost too. You know, Chrom grab doesn't really get too much off of it, but again, grab does beat shield, and he's just misspacing it. He's getting in position where those throws can connect. He just needs to get the grab first.
Nice response here by Acetyl, catching Frost. Probably deciding to do like a slight mix-up with the side B. He's going for the 3 swipes instead of the full hip-hop, full combo. But now it's actually Frost who's got Acetyl in a bad state of affairs, but excellent recovery by Acetyl.
Perfect timing. He recognized that Frost was probably going to drop down low and go for an option like a forward air or something, and he's going to throw out the holy water to intercept him at ledge yet again.
Like a heat-seeking missile, Acetyl just absolutely on one with these F-smashes.
Lingering projectiles are the thing that kills Prom's recovery, and then having a long-distance smash attack option as well is quite strong, too.
I love this setup here by Acetyl. You see he was trying to basically catch Frost going for a jump for the most part. He had like three options out there. It's crazy. I really love to see that.
He's got really good knowledge of when his projectiles are going to work in the air or on platforms. He uses platforms really well as well.
Yeah, PS2 affords Richter a lot of angles and options some other stages won't as well. It's got the platform height and the distance to ledge.
Right, yeah. So it's worth noting that Winner's Quarters is a best of three, too. So if Frost can't get some momentum going on here, he might very well find himself in the loser's bracket.
Yeah, and this would be an upset, right? Just by rankings?
It would be, yeah. I believe Frost is our fifth seed tonight. Or, no, Acetyl's our fourth seed. Frost is our fifth seed.
Gotcha. So this is expected to be a very close set right now. Acetyl is doing his best job to make sure that it's not close at all. That confirm at the right side of the ledge was crazy. Just catch up on the action here. Trying to get Frost into a tech chase situation. Not quite going to get it.
You know, we've been talking a lot about what Acetyl's doing, but Frost has been using a lot of mix-ups on shield. He's been getting a lot of pressure with, like, landing aerials, jabs, and then disengages, trying to greet rolls. And they're just now starting to work a little bit. So if the set runs long and Frost can actually take this game, I'm expecting us to see a game three situation where he is completely on top of what Acetyl does out of shield.
A good DI out. That was a very awkward angle for Frost to catch Acetyl puppy, and Acetyl was able to escape, but there's no escape in this flurry of swords from Frost right now.
Dude, do you see that? He wave bounced his side B so that he got a little bit of backward momentum so the down smash from Acetyl wouldn't hit him off stage. That's incredibly well played from Acetyl, or from Frost, but I think it might be too little too late as this percent continues to climb.
He has to get back to center stage somehow. Almost there. There we go. He got it.
Woo. Yeah, good 17% there off of that upbeat. He's going to get a back air, too, to catch the lingering dash attack on the platform.
Yeah, that dash
attack. He's got rage, input. Too.
Yeah, Acetyl has to be very careful. He has to be very smart with how he spaced out his whip and not go for grab whiffs like that.
These are the situations, though, my friend, where Frost really comes alive. He is so good in these high-pressure situations. Well, and Acetyl is, too.
Did you see that movement? That movement from Frost was so good to get out of the corner. Uh-oh, but the dash attack, the down smash is not enough to hit the kill! Oh, man. Acetyl
really good
wanted
mix-up.
That.
I've been seeing T3 Dom employ those a lot, too. It's really good. Down tilt is a good mix-up option that a lot of people haven't realized until recently.
Oh, it's Belmont's burst range option at a distance, and you obviously being down tilt's going to get past a lot of options. At worst, your opponent jumps over you. So, yeah, and a cross-up, exactly. Oh, man, that backer. I thought that was going to do it. Frost.
Yeah, I thought so, too, with the rage. Oh, yeah, there's the F tilt, though. We're going to game three.
That wasn't even sweet spotted. That was just like at the regular range of the sword. Still really good by Frost. Oh, no, go on.
Prompt doesn't have sour spots, bro.
Oh, right. I always think that that's what he carries over from Roy. But that's the difference between two characters.
Yeah.
No, the thing that it's really complimentary about Frost's play there is just how willing he was to hang in there. Against the Belmonts, it can be lesser players are just going to get so frustrated that they're just going to go for, you know, yellow options. But Frost was able to just play, keep it cool long enough to get us to a game three.
Yes, Shorter Ames informed me that Acetyl usually wins when these two meet up in bracket. So I'm inclined to believe that this might be a good chance for Frost to get some brownie points for his mental game if he can win this matchup.
Yeah. He's getting some brownie points for me with that flurry of attacks off stage there a moment ago. That was really stylish.
Yeah, I'm just saying, whenever Frost is in advantage, he puts the pedal to the metal in a big way. But Acetyl's very much the same way. I just feel like Acetyl plays a character that's really good at defense, but Frost's mental game is really good at defense as well, and it's really ambitious whenever you put your opponent in tech chase situations like that one.
Absolutely. Frost capitalizing. Now it's up to Acetyl to try to start bringing this back.
Woo. And Frost, taking that stock so early is huge, considering how long Acetyl's been living for most of these stocks this set.
Yeah. That said, though, this is Yoshi, so early stocks is what I expect.
Yeah, I agree. And I feel like the angles are, I don't know why Acetyl picked the stage, because I feel like the angles might mess up the holy water a little bit.
Belmonts actually don't do too badly on the triplats, as far as I know.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I know they like Battlefield, but like I feel like the slants on Yoshi's are like freaking me out.
Well,
I don't know. I think you know something I don't.
Possibly. He was able to clean things up there and take us to a second stock.
Yeah, he's gonna throw out the cross to cover his landing too, and he's gonna go for a rising angle down forward air off the ledge.
Love those angles Belmonts can get.
Oh, like an elevator. Yeah, he dragged down Nair to Uppy.
Yeah, the holy elevator.
Yeah, that's a good name for the combo, actually. Hold on. I'm writing that down.
Uh-oh. Man, and we were just talking about the down tilts and the down airs there, basically. Acetyl's getting a lot of usage out of that. Maybe that's why he likes Yoshi's, because it might, like, just kind of corner Krom from not wanting to play in ledge. I think that might have to be more to do with it, to be honest with you. Because right now we're seeing Frost is kind of stuck in, like, second gear. You can't really, like, get free.
Oh my god, that angle back air too is super close as well. And he's gonna get hit to the other side of the stage. Honestly, I feel like that might be better for him than if he went to the ledge, because he had a little bit more space.
Yeah. We just found out whose uppy is faster.
Yeah, we did.
Oh no!
Oh, and a border! Nice catch on the tether recovery there too. Frost is in the lead.
Yeah, Frost saw his window.
First time going into last
dot. He saw his window closing. He was like, I'm gonna go for it. He'd love to see that.
Man, he's still young. He hasn't learned fear yet.
Well, speaking of fear, parrying at that distance, he's got to put some fear in any Belmont main. Like, uh-oh, he got my F-tilt. I'm supposed to get that for free all the time.
That's my main grounded option. You can't punish that generally unless you parry it. Okay. I like the stutter step, too. He's trying to go for the spike, but it's not going to happen. Acetyl gets the ledge just in time.
Really good by Frost. He's taking the game back by the scruff of the neck. Oh.
Yeah. I expected the up smash there.
Oh, I mean, that up B was a really good call, but you're right. I think maybe the side B would have caught, like, it has a wider window to connect because it's a multi hit. But,
right.
Like I said, we can't, no idea if that was an input or not. Misinput or not, because we're not in any players' heads.
But now we see Acetyl back at center, Fro, and he is really comfy in his little cage there, surrounded by all the platforms, and he's got a ton of space between him and Frost.
Excellent down smash decision there, too. You're right, Blair. This is just making it really hard for Frost to get back in at all. Acetyl's doing a good job, and he got it!
Oh
my gosh. On the button, that back air gonna connect, and it just... chipping and chipping and chipping away and getting straight hits and, you know, just dropping shields.